sudung ang atong dakbayan nang inahanglan ug tabang nagbaguod sa kadaghan sa kalisod nga gisaguban. Untai nga nato ni pasagdan, walay di masulbad kong talan, magkahiusa lang sa pagpagkamana. Alang sa usag usa kita ragyud ang kayang gahong anaa sa katawan, kinsa pa man di ay ang magtinabangay, kinsa pa man di ay ang maginunungay, kinsa pa man di ay ang magdayong kataragi hapon ba. Malikunta ang kalinatagang tamay na kaaswagan di atong dakbayan. Maunggiyaw ang tanan, isaragyod ang atong katuwasan kay ang gahong anak. Kinsa pa man di ay ang
Cristiano, Virginia, Esang, Eling, Maxi, Conchita, Cheching, Isagani, Roberto, Leandro, Marino, Bonita, Perla, Berina, Suping, Sebastian, Anatalio, Irene, Ditas, Pedro Sr., Sotera, Dennis, Hazel, Paterno, Dulce, Efren, Ningning, Gaudencio, Benjamin, Jose, Bernadette, Angela, Leting, Ramon Sr., Monching, Gigi, Salvacion, Baring, Venancio, Baring, Alipio, Praxedes, Emilio, Inez, Paz, Julian, Hereno, Segundina, Joseph, Sidney, Ignacio Sr. and Jr., Celestino, Ignacio, Ramoncito, Edgardo, Rodrigo, Romulo Sr., Tomas, Felicidad, Hermine, Hilda, Jose, Yolanda, Irene, Lourdes, Felisa, Emilia, Oscar, Nicky, Ben Sr., Filomeno, Concepcion, Socorro, Manuelita, Aleya, Fabular, Jesus de los Reyes, Ponciano, Cabilan Sr., Alan Cabrera, Peter Elaya, Frank, John, Lauren Pagar, Francisco Pagar, Monico Sr., Socorro, Eleuteria, Tirso Honorato Sr., Innocencia Marie, Leonardo Jr., Pura Jose, Michael Douglas, Suzette Milagros, Klaus Dieter Preussner, Estanislao Tapic, Max and Elfrida Preussner, Hannah Lore and Willie Preussner, Albert and Adelheide Stoudmeister, Marcelo Diaz, Jennifer and Sunny Batulan, Serian Visitacion Gongog, Hilario Saavedra, Primo Eliaca, Hospicio Rabadon, Josefina and Ferdinand Bantilan, Camila, Moises, Expedita, Encarnacion, Maria Gina, Marvin, Pedro, Roland, Jose Tapic, Jose Bahian, Eugenio Asuncion, Mamerto, Narciso, Robinson, Virgilio, Felipa, Mario de los Reyes, Mary, Jesus, Teresa, Miguel, Pasing, Rosila, Baby, Andres, Dayadima, Emiliano, Marcos, Eutiquio, Cristina, Euterio, Candida, Pedro, Macaria, Felix, Narcisa, Ricardo, Flor, Salvacion, Necitos, Honorato Sr., Angeles, Ponciano, Junicio, Selvina, Felisa, Percival, Alejandro, Chodolfa, Peter, Wilbur, Teresito, Fortunato Jr., Erohito, Dominga, Erlinda, Amelia, Chofisto, Baol, Rosita, Vibar, Reynaldo, Menjola, Juan, Materna, Maria, Primo, Jobil, Faith, Estrellita, Elvira, Jerry, Norma, Juanita, Eufemia, Carolina, Ponce, Lenaida, Leonardo Simbahon Sr. and Jr., Emiliana, Simeon, Honey, Felipe, Geralda, Arcadio, Tola, Marciano, Marciana, Mauricio, Utopia, Modesto, Candido, Remedios, William, Mary, Phyllis, Cipriano, Rolando, Mauro, Maria Plaridel Seno, Rodrigo Haralve, Pastora Acorin, Felizardo de Los Angeles, Wilfredo Quiroga, Maria Nanette Haralve, Edwin Lazaga, Godofredo Angioscoro Kapangpangan, Juan and Eufronia Kapangpangan, Caridad Formoso, Jonathan Sotes, Florencia Kabatingan, Weda Nif, Elena Oping, Victor Berting, Gori Enis, Henyo Tinay, Merto Rita Lalucha Inigo Sr., Angeline, Jesus, Florencia, Bart, Virgie, Mike, Boy, Jingle, Donato, Angelina, Paulina, Demetrio, Rodolfo, Lorenzo, Alberto Sr., Sabina, Telma, Herlan, Demetrio Sr., Bandilia, Leonides, Nadal, Jeronimo and Lydia Destua, Catalina Pusa, Baldomero, Nadal Jr., Antonio Ayala, Oligario, Madera, Nadal Sr., Madera Sr., Magdaleno, Rosalina, Avelino, Victoriano, Maria, Emilio, Jesus, Lerena, Eduardo, Gloria, Pedro, Flor, Marvin, Nick, Dorcas, Patrocinio, Jaime, Catalina, Boyet, Reynaldo, Emetrio, Milagros, Edmundo, Moreno. Seventh day of the novena for Felipe Tan. 27th anniversary, death anniversary of Araceli Fuentes. 40th day of Angeles Cabilan. Third day novena for Virgilio Elaya. Birthday and death anniversary of baby angel. Death anniversary of Benjamin Co and Caridad. For all souls in purgatory, the forgotten ones and those who died of COVID-19. Let us now prepare ourselves for the celebration of the Holy Eucharist. Please all stand.
Our God and King. He is the rock of our salvation. In the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, welcome to our Eucharistic celebration on this August 5 online Mass at 12:15 in the afternoon. Let us offer this Holy Mass for our personal and family intentions. Today we celebrate the 148th Institute Day of the Daughters of Mary, Help of Christians. And we take this time to pray for them and the sisters, that the Lord will bless them with vocations and continue to inspire them to continue their mission. Among our intentions, we also pray the good health, safety of all our parishioners, frontline health workers and their families, seafarers and their families, Wilcrest Appliance Corporation family, all unborn and aborted babies, and the intentions of Marie Williamson, Albert and Criselda Lim, Pasitaong, Cookie Uy, Carmen C., Davidal, Bacalso, Cabanya Mondero, Matunog, Rosal, Bacosmo, Panugaling, Alvar, Alunan, Apari families. We also pray in this Holy Mass thanksgiving for those celebrating their birthdays today, especially for Mads Vestil, Lloyd Bacalso, Chona Gerenya, Kent Balansag, Mercedes Bordon, and baby Scarlett Matar. Also in thanksgiving for the gift of our Salesian sisters, especially here in the parish, for Sister Eva, Sister Angie, Sister Claudia, and Sister Geraldine. And we also entrust to the Lord healing and spiritual strength of those who are sick, especially for Dr. Halimane Raganath, Sophia, Father George, Justice Poy, Lyndon Ruiz, Junjun Lim, Luz Nang Isang, Rogelio Lucmayon, Leslie Soliban, Elena Bernasor, Lara Damole, Dr. Pasita C., April Jereza, Dalen Gloria, Flor Apape, James Arsenio Ponce, Gary Borelli, Wilma Yu, Brennan Pelayo, Nove Kim Wisley, Rosalia Noel Tan, Ray Claveria, Ferdinand Canales. And also we pray for those who have died, especially for Teresita Alvarez, Teresito Yap, Pat Belsinia, Felipe Tan, Lily Minoso, Juana Valencia, Claridel Seno, Constancio Pepito, Alejandro Escala, Laura Del Pansoy, Matilde Adolfo, Christine Micaballo, Gloria Sumalinog, Dominador Reyes Sr., and Maria Corazon Origines, Presentacion Rueda, Arnold Abayan Sr., Eugenio Sr., Pelagia Soledad, Leia Villa Chudurico, Alan Adarna, Virginia Abadia. Brothers and sisters, let us now begin as we call to mind our sins.
Lord Jesus, you came to reconcile us to one another and to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
ask you intercede for us with your Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest. Let us pray. Pardon the faults of your servants, we pray, O Lord, that we who cannot please you by our own deeds may be saved through the intercession of the Mother of your Son and our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated for the liturgy of the word.
A proclamation from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The descendants of my people shall be renowned among nations, and their offspring among the peoples. All who see them shall acknowledge them as a race the Lord has blessed. I rejoice heartily in the Lord, in my God is the joy of my soul, for he has clothed me with a robe of salvation, and wraps me in a mantle of justice. Like a bridegroom adorned with a diadem, like a bride bedecked with her jewels. As the earth brings forth its plants, and a garden makes its growth spring up, so will the Lord God make justice and praise spring up before all the nations. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Panginoon, ang aking pastor. Inakaya ko sa tahimik na batis at dulot niya'y bagong lakas. Tapat sa pangakong ako'y sasamahan niya sa tuwid na landa.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Praised be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has bestowed on us in Christ every spiritual blessing in the heavens. God chose us in Him before the world began to be holy and blameless in His sight, to be full of love. He likewise predestined us through Jesus Christ to be His adopted sons and daughters. Such was His will and pleasure, that all might praise the divine favor He has bestowed on us in His beloved. In Him we were chosen, for in the decree of God, who administers everything according to His will and counsel, we were predestined to praise His glory by being the first to hope in Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please all stand to honor the Holy Gospel.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus withdrew to the region of Tyre and Sidon, and behold, a Canaanite woman of that district came and called out, "Have pity on me, Lord, Son of David. My daughter is tormented by a demon." But he did not say a word in answer to her. His disciples came and asked him, "Send her away, for she keeps calling out after us." Jesus said in reply, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." But the woman came and did him homage, saying, "Lord, help me." He said in reply, "It is not right to take the food of the children and throw it to the dogs." She said in reply, "Please, Lord, for even the dogs eat the scraps that fall from the table of their masters." Then Jesus said to her in reply, "O woman, great is your faith. Let it be done for you as you wish." And her daughter was healed at that very hour. Sisters and brothers, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated for the homily.
Maayong hapon kanatong tanan. It's good to see that our church, although in front of me it's empty, at least here in the side, not full of beautiful and smiling people. Because today we are celebrating the 148th Institute Day of the Daughters of Mary Help of Christians. It is a time to celebrate, and it is a day of thanksgiving. Atong pagpakan ang mga Daughters of Mary Help of Christians. Makadungog mo sa ilang pakpak, daghan-daghan, ubay-ubay, kundi silang pakanoon nilang sister. And as we thank God for the gift of the Institute, we thank also Sister Eva, Sister Geraldine, Sister Angie, Sister Claudia for their presence in our parish. Sisters, thank you very much for your selfless service and your ungrudging contribution to our parish community. And as we celebrate and thank God for the gift of the Institute and the sisters, we also pray for them. And we assure you of the prayers of our community that the Lord will bless your Institute with vocation and bless your mission. And as speaking about prayer, our gospel reading from Matthew chapter 15 speaks about prayer. Here is a very beautiful example, inspiring example of a Canaanite woman. Probably this woman is of pagan origin. We don't know if she believes in the God of Israel, but nonetheless, she comes to Jesus and she has faith in Jesus. And her gesture is a very beautiful example of how we are to pray. Di ako natuyo sa kabata, no, during this time of pandemic, no, nobody is here in the church, but the parish priest noticed a child, no, a boy of about 10 years old. He was coming to the church and he was praying. And as he was praying, kneeling down in church, he was alone. His prayer was like this: "Lord, please give me a bike." No, he wanted a bicycle. And so he waited. It was a very simple but sincere prayer. After 1 week, he waited if God will give him his bike. But no bike arrived. So again, the next week, he again prayed. Came to the church all alone, and he prayed, "Lord, please give me a bike." Again, he waited. After 1 week, still no bike from God. And so he became impatient, but still very persistent. And one morning, the parish priest noticed, that the statue of Mary our Birhen sa Lourdes na wagtang naman. And there, the priest found a note. And the priest read the note, and the boy scribbled these words, "Dear Lord, if you still want to see your mother, please give me your bike. Give me my bike." Kaluoy ni Mary, no, na hostage na inoon. The point of this amusing story, brothers and sisters, is that it is difficult to pray. And much more difficult to pray when God is silent, when He doesn't hear. And sometimes we are tempted. No, maybe God is not there, or He is angry with us. That's why He does not give us, or He does not listen to us. And that's why our gospel reading from Matthew chapter 15, verses 21 to 28, about this Canaanite woman, is an inspiring example how we ought to pray. Because this woman has a great, great need, not for herself, but for her daughter. Because her daughter was greatly tormented by a demon. And here, you feel the love of a mother, willing to do anything, willing even to sacrifice herself, willing even to swallow her pride, just for her daughter, who was in pain and suffering, just for her to get well. But strangely, Jesus was not in a welcoming mood. He did not react when the woman came to him. And actually, it seems through the disciples that Jesus was sending her away. But this woman is very persistent. And in the end, her wish and her prayer was answered. Her daughter got healed at that very moment. Three lessons I'd like to reflect with you about this woman, this Canaanite woman, brothers and sisters. Number one, that our prayer should not only be for ourselves. When we pray, it should include also others. When we pray, no, let us not just bring to the Lord our own prayers. Our prayer should not be selfish or self-centered. Instead, when we pray, of course, while we have our own needs, there is a greater need outside. There is a greater need of the parish. There is a greater need of the world. Today, for example, in this time of pandemic, we should intercede for others and pray for the needs of so many people much more suffering than us. And today, as we celebrate, you know, the 148th anniversary or Institute Day of the Sisters, you know, this reminds us of the role of priest and religious. You know, last Sunday, I was sharing in my homily, you know, that the priest, and I think that also includes the religious, one of our role here in the parish, we are tig. No, tig is a pun in Bisaya, which means we are servants. No, we are doing, no, this service. Kami tig ampu. No, that is our role. We pray. We pray. Therefore, we are intercessors, especially for others. We bring the prayers of others to the Lord. In this Mass, for example, I really take time not to read, no, personal prayers and personal intentions of those whom I know, parishioners and many others, no, who ask me to pray for them. And I think that is our role, no, the sister's role and the father's role. And we can also become intercessors for others. In other words, our prayers should not only be for ourselves, also include others. Second lesson, our prayers should be habitual. Our prayers should not be a one-time event. It should be part of us. It should be our lifestyle. Prayers should be like breathing. No, when we breathe, we don't think anymore. No, when we breathe, because breathing should be automatic. It should be natural. and when we breathe, it's life-giving. I think that is what prayer is all about. It should be natural, automatic. It is life-giving. It should be part of us, no, when we pray. And that's why we pray not just once. No, some people, no, when they have great need, no, they make the novena, no, or you are a student, no, and you make the bar exam or before the board exam, and you promise God to be better, to do this and that, but after you have received wish granted, makalimot na kas Ginoo, di na kamo simba. Prayer should be something habitual. And Jesus, here in our gospel reading, somehow she sends away the woman. And in the tone of the Lord's voice, it might even seem that he was insulting the woman, calling her a dog. No, do not let the dogs eat, no, from the table of the masters. But also the woman answered very beautifully, "Please, Lord, even the dogs eat the scraps that fall from the master's table." Here, brothers and sisters, the woman was persistent with her request. She did not waver, she did not lose heart, she was not even scandalized. She came to Jesus and worshiped him and asked him, "Lord, please help me." And you can feel her humility and her faith. And because of that, Jesus heard her prayers. And finally, our problems should lead us to God, not away from him. And we know that in Christian life, it is full of difficulties and problems. We are in a spiritual battle. We are in a struggle constantly. All the more now, we have this COVID pandemic. Jesus even says that in our life, in following him, we take up his cross. And that's why here, brothers and sisters, we should also ask the Lord to change our paradigm, looking at prayer and looking at how we suffer and how we take on the battles and the adversities of our life. Saint James, in his letter, even said, "Count it joy when you have trials." No, kalisod, no? Joy ko, no, kung nakay trial. Okay rana, Ma'am Erica? Count it pure joy, no, if you are under trial. Imagine, you should be joyful when you are trial, na-stress na inong ka, ma-joyful pa ka. But this is something we have to learn. And we have to change, the paradigm of how we see things, especially in the eyes of faith. And that's why, brothers and sisters, it's an invitation to trust. It's an invitation to surrender, especially in prayer. Today, brothers and sisters, these are the three lessons we can learn from the simple, unknown Canaanite woman. We don't know of her origin and her background, but she had a great faith, believing in Jesus. And these are the three things we can learn from her, that our prayer should not only be for ourselves, but it should include others. We become intercessors for others and for the world. And secondly, that our prayers should be something habitual. It becomes part of us, our lifestyle. And when we have problems, it should lead us closer to the Lord, not away from him. Because, as Saint James said, we should count it a blessing, and we count it as joy when we are tested by the Lord, because our faith shines. Amen. Please all stand for the prayers of the faithful. Let us pray to our Lord Jesus Christ, with whom the glory of God has been revealed, that we may recognize him today, especially through Saint Mary Mazzarello's love for all, grateful for all that he has given us. We respond to the Lord as we say, "Lord, we thank you."
for the gift of the Church and her leaders, whose zeal and dedication brings all the children of God closer to salvation. May they proclaim the gospel through their words and deeds. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, we thank you.
For the untiring efforts of our government leaders and their commitment to work with integrity and transparency, upholding always the good of the people above their personal interests, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, we thank you.
For the daughters of Mary, help of Christians, and their desire to become women of prayer, and their passion for the salvation of souls, and in their daily witnessing to the love of God, may they continue and pass on the legacy of Mother Mazzarello and the First Sisters of Mornese, who lived in a spirit of joy, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, we thank you.
For the Salesians of Don Bosco, who administer to our sacramental needs, and for their efforts to become another Christ, the Good Shepherds, may they draw strength from God's all-embracing love that renews and transforms life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, we thank you.
For the members of our educating community that shares in the educative mission of the Salesian Sisters for the good of the young, may they find meaning in contributing to greater communion as together we build and create a home for the young. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, we thank you.
For the gift of the young, whose presence continues to challenge the Salesian family, may they grow daily in goodness and grace that leads them to fullness of life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, we thank you.
For all of us gathered here, that inspired by the love and passion of the Sisters of Mornese in bringing Jesus to all, may we nourish our relationship with Jesus and have him as the center of our existence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, we thank you.
We also include in our intentions the good health, safety, protection of all our parishioners, especially here in Lourdes Parish, for the frontline health workers and their families, seafarers and their families, Wilcris Appliance Corporation family. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, we thank you.
We also thank the Lord, and we also pray for the intentions of those celebrating their birthdays, especially for Mads Vestil, Lloyd Macalso, Chona Guerenia, Kent Balansag, Mercedes Bordon, Scarlett Matar, that the Lord will bless them with good health and bless them with all the graces that they need every day. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, we thank you.
And we bring to the Lord, through the intercession of our Blessed Mother, Our Lady of Lourdes, health of the sick, healing, recovery, and spiritual strength, especially of Dr. Halimane Raganat, Sophia, Father George, Justice Poy, Lindon Ruiz, Junjun Lim, Luz Nang Isang, Rogelio Lucmayon, Leslie Suliban, Elena Bernasor, Lala Damole, Dr. Pasita C., April Jereza, Dalen Gloria, Flor Apape, James Arsenio Ponce, Gary Borelli, Wilma Yu, Brennan Pelayo, Nove, Kimberly, Wesley, Rosalia, Noel Tan, Ray Claveria, Ferdinand, and those COVID positive in Barangay Punta, Tisa, Mambaling, and Labangon. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, we thank you.
We ask you all these, Heavenly Father, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Oh,
Please all stand.
Pray that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, we ask, the prayers of your people with the sacrificial offerings, that through the intercession of Blessed Mary, the mother of your Son, no petition may go unanswered, no request be made in vain, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise your mighty deeds in the exaltation of all your saints, especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to proclaim your kindness as we echo her thankful hymn of praise. For truly even to earth's ends you have done great things and extended your abundant mercy from age to age. When you looked on the lowliness of your handmaid, you gave us, through her, the author of our salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, joined with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it. He gave it to all his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving you thanks and praise, he gave it to all his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Constancio Pipito, Alejandro Escala, Laura Del Pansoy, Matilde Adolfo, Christine Micaballo, Gloria Somalino, Dominador Reyes Senior, Maria Corazon Origines, Presentacion Ruedas, Arnaldo Abayan Sr., Eugenio Sr., Pelagia Soledad, Lea Villa, Chodorico, Alan Adarna, Virginia Abadia, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that they who are united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also all our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Our Lady of Lourdes, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint John Bosco, Saint Mary Mazzarello, Saint Bernadette Subiru, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Please all stand.
As one family, as brothers and sisters, let us now call on God, our Father. Our Father, who art in heaven, kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, especially the evil of COVID-19. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you all.
And with your spirit.
We offer one another the sign of peace. Dear friends, behold Jesus. He is the Lamb of God who takes away our sins. Blessed are we who are invited at the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body of Christ bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us now make the act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be ever separated from you. Amen. The body of Christ.
Amen.
My soul is thirsting for the joy that comes from you alone. My being like the earth is parched and lifeless. Without you by my side, I lose my way.
In you, O Lord, is my strength and my salvation. Soul shall find its rest. You are my song, my glory, the rock of my strength. Your constant love is my refuge.
Your kindness is greater good than life. My lips shall glorify your name forever, Lord. And I will tell my friends of your great love, the goodness you have shown me from of old.
In you, O Lord, is my strength and my salvation. Soul shall find its rest. You are my song, my glory, the rock of my strength. Your constant love is my refuge.
heart is deeply troubled, filled with insecurities. But you are there to lead me all the way. You take me by the hand, I'm not alone.
In you, O Lord, is my strength and my salvation.
Is my refuge.
Please all stand.
Let us pray. As we receive this heavenly sacrament, we beseech you, O Lord, your mercy, that we who rejoice in commemorating the Blessed Virgin Mary may by imitating her serve worthily the mystery of our redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please all kneel.
Oratio imperata against COVID-19. God our Father, we come to you in our need to ask your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and even claimed lives. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. Protect the medical experts that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. We pray for those affected. May they be restored to health soon. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in this trying time to work for the good of all and to help those in need. We implore you to stop the spread of the virus and to save us from our fears. Amen. Prayer to Our Lady, Health of the Sick. We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition and our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and blessed Virgin. Amen. Our Lady, Health of the Sick,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
San Roque,
pray for us.
San Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Saint Mary Mazzarello,
pray for us.
Saint John Bosco,
pray for us. Please all stand.
Brothers and sisters, before we end, again, thank you very much for continually supporting us and following us in our online masses. And please continue to do so if you have been blessed by our masses. And I'd like to congratulate, cheers for the Daughters of Mary Help of Christians for celebrating 148th Institute Day. A big hand for them. Congratulations, sisters, Sister Eva and her companions. And I'd like to greet also happy birthday to Mads Vestil, Lloyd Bacalso, Chonag Guerenya, Kent Balansag, Mercedes Bordon, and baby Scarlett Matar on her third birthday. Happy birthday. Enjoy your day. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you and your families, the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass has been offered. Let us go in the peace and love of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Saints to the mountains, sing to the sea. Raise your voices, lift your hearts. This is the day the Lord has made.
Let all the earth rejoice.
I will give thanks to you, my Lord. You have answered my plea. You have saved my soul from death. You are my strength and my song. Glad and rejoice. He has turned all death to life. Sing of the glory of God.
Sing to the mountains, sing to the sea. Raise your voices, lift.